wave of coronavirus pandemic has caused more deaths than the first wave. In this episode, we'll try and understand why the second wave has been more dangerous and why India has been affected so badly. I am Adeline Bhana Minch, and we'll have all the questions answered in this episode of Let's Know COVID-19 Better. Things had started to get better towards the end of the last year and the beginning of this year, and that's when people started to relax. They were carefree and let their guards down. And then the second wave of coronavirus hit us. Where did India go wrong, and how did we not see this coming?
As the vaccination drive started in January and February, cases started to go down. People stopped adhering to COVID protocols and started going about the business as was in the pre-COVID era. This resulted in the rapid spread of the virus.
The double mutated COVID virus B.1.617, which was first found in Maharashtra, made the second wave more deadly.
As a part of evolutionary biology, viruses mutate all the time. Some mutations weaken the virus, while some make it strong. This enables the virus to grow faster and cause more infections. In this case, the virus mutated in its genome at two places, hence known as double mutated virus. The mutations in this variant decreases the binding of the antibodies to the virus, which is important for our immune system to destroy the virus and control the infection.
Our priorities in the last few months were on the state elections and the Kumbh Mela, where COVID protocols were not followed, resulting in the virus spreading rapidly.
India's political parties were campaigning for a series of state elections in West Bengal, Assam, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu, as well as local council elections in some parts of Uttar Pradesh and Telangana. The campaigning started early March, and voting started at the end of March and continued in April. The campaigns have often involved numerous rallies with large crowds and minimal social distancing, and no COVID protocols were followed. Kumbh Mela was held in Haridwar from January 14 to April 27, where 70 lakh people had participated and one out of every 5 persons tested positive.
A report published by The Lancet, which is an international medical journal, states that coronavirus can also act as an airborne pathogen.
A paper written by 6 experts from the US, UK and Canada states that the virus can even spread without direct contact with the infected person through long transmission, even after several hours, hence proving it an airborne virus. Another study done in MIT reveals that the effectiveness of social distancing of 6 feet is negligible in preventing person-to-person spread of COVID, and this can be due to the primary reason that the COVID virus spreads through airborne transmission also.
Increased testing is another reason why India is detecting more cases in the second wave of the COVID-19 pandemic.
By the time the second wave hit India, the availability of COVID-19 testing had improved tremendously compared to the first wave. Since more tests are done, more cases are being detected.
The third wave of coronavirus, as the experts have suggested, is just around the corner. And let's learn from our mistakes this time. Let's follow the COVID protocols and help the country win the war against this pandemic. I hope this video was informative. Stay tuned for more stories on the pandemic. Stay safe, stay indoors, and get vaccinated.